Hello, my name is Donette Douglas. I'm the station manager here at WTJR Channel 16 in Quincy, Illinois. The program you're watching right now is Behind the Scenes, and we tape this program here in the studio at 222 North 6th Street, and it's on the second floor of the building. And this program is exciting. Yeah, we always got a lot to tell you, don't we? And I'll tell you, I just am so thankful that we get to broadcast good news from this station. I'm so thankful for our wonderful staff that we have here, our volunteers. We have newsletter volunteers. We have prayer intercessors that we send a prayer letter to. We have volunteer camera operators, production help, phone operators, and we're just so thankful for each and every one of them. Because it takes all of us. It does take all of us. And it also takes you, the viewer. It takes you that is praying for us out there. And it takes those that financially support us. And we want to thank CTN, Christian Television Network from Clearwater, Florida. They are the owners of WTJR. And they help us in so many, many ways. But most of all, we want to say thank you, God. Because His hand has been on this ministry, guiding and leading and directing, providing. And it's the power of God, the Holy Spirit, that comes into your, wherever you're watching this program at, and speaks to your heart. And He can make an eternal difference in your life. Amen. And we get to be a part of that. So I say, hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Well, we don't have any pictures this week to show you, so we're just going to start right up because I got a new update on moving on to HD. Yep, we're excited here. We're applauding what God's doing and what you're helping us to do here as we're moving on to HD, high definition, production upgrade. We'll need switcher. We'll need cameras and some lighting equipment that we want to changes, I should say, we want to do here in the studio. But we got a video a little later on we're going to show you that our engineer made that will put this in detail for you. But our new total as of today, $16,115. Thank you, thank you, thank you. We're getting closer to the $20,000 every single day. And we say thank you. Can't say thank you enough. Amen. But we still need some help. So if you would be willing to send a donation here to WTJR, be sure you mark HD Fund on it, okay? So we get it into the right account so we can use it for this production upgrade HD high definition here at WTJR. Amen. Amen. Okay, prayer. You know, I love to talk about prayer. And we spend a lot of time in prayer here at WTJR because we know that is our direct contact with Jesus, with God, our Heavenly Father. And Jesus Christ is sitting at His right hand, interceding, praying for us. So praise God for prayer. Amen. So we would like to invite you to join us on Mondays from 1 to 2 p.m. right here in the WTJR studio. We are on the second floor of the building, but we have an elevator. So you can get up here easily and join us for prayer and stand in faith as we pray for our nation, for our city, for CTN, WTJR. We may lift up prayer requests that you have because people call in with prayer requests all the time. So we want to stand in faith and keep praying for them. And we'll pray with your prayer request if you join us here for prayer. If you need prayer, call 217-228-1616. And also, you can email pray16@wtjr.org or you can go on our Facebook page, okay? And get your prayer request to us. Pray 16, that's our live call-in prayer show that airs on Fridays, 11 a.m. to 12 noon, hosted by Pastor Gary Wallace, and he is the pastor of River of Life Church here in Quincy, Illinois. And we have guest pastors that are with him each week. And we also repeat the program on Mondays at 9 p.m. And even though it's a repeat program, we do have a phone operator, so you can still call in your prayer requests, your praise reports, or like we said, you can also email pray16@wtjr.org. Soul winning training, if you're interested in being trained to go out and tell people about Jesus, you know, it's not really that hard. It really isn't. Once you do it, and once someone says yes to Jesus, it gets easier, I guarantee you. So we use a soul winning script from the Great Awakening. You can call the station here, phone number on the screen. We'll be glad to train you individually, or maybe you have a group, or we'll come to your church and train. But we'll pray with you, we'll train, and we'll go out on the streets and tell people about Jesus. Amen. We have a booklet, if you would like to have, called Seek God for the City. And it's a 40-day prayer devotional book, I should say. It has prayers and devotions in for 40 days, starting February the 14th up through Palm Sunday, which is March the 25th. And they are 40 prayers of biblical hope. And if you're interested in one of these booklets, you can call us. I'll put one in the mail to you. If your church would be interested, if you call, we'll give you a phone number or a place you can call and order the booklets for your church. But we would like to have you join us as we seek God for the city 2018. Amen. Also, I want to invite you to a very special event here at the WTJR studio. Elisha Impartation Conference. That will be on Friday, February the 16th at 7 p.m. You need to be here at 6 p.m. when the doors open to register and greet and fellowship a little bit with people. And Evangelist Robert Newton will be bringing a message then at 7 p.m. On Saturday, February the 17th at 10:30 a.m., session one will start with Dr. Ron Brees. At 12 noon, we have lunch served here in the studio, so we need you to RSVP and let us know if you're coming, so we'll have a count for lunch that day. 2 p.m., session number two starts with Steve Douthart. At 3 p.m., we have a leadership activity. At 3:30 p.m., we have session number three with Evangelist Bob Newton. 5 p.m. we take a dinner break, and at that time you go out and whatever restaurant you want to go to in Quincy, and you're on your own for your dinner. But at 7 p.m. we invite you to come back for the impartation service with Dr. Ron Brees. There is no charge for this. We would love to have you come. Come expecting. I have attended these, several of them, and I'm always so blessed by the Lord. He gives me a word. He encourages me, maybe helps me with I'm trying to make some decisions in my life, and it seems like the word was just for me to help me do that. And so I just want to encourage you to come February the 16th and the 17th for this Elisha Impartation Conference. There's no charge, but please RSVP so we can have a count for lunch on Saturday. Thank you. Pray 16, our live call-in prayer show right here on WTJR. Well, we're going to have a special three-hour program on Saturday, February 24th. I mean, some of you watched in January when we had our special 3 hours. It's from 7 p.m. to 10 p.m., and we have three different pastors. We start with Pastor Gary Wallace and his wife, Paula, from River of Life Church here in Quincy. Then we have Pastor Chuck Hetzler and his wife, Karen, with the First Union Congregational Church here in Quincy. And then we have Randy Holliday and his wife, Darlene, and they have the Secret Place Prayer Ministry in Hannibal, Missouri. So mark that on your calendar, Saturday, February 24th, Pray 16, live. 3 hours. Postage stamps, we're still collecting, and the money is used to purchase books for missionaries to teach the kids in other countries, wherever they're stationed. You can either drop them off by the studio, or a lot of you put them in your envelope when you send your donation check, and I say thank you for that. Coming up on A Woman's Joy, then next week is our dear friend and sister in Christ, Sherry McDaniel. And Sherry comes once a month. We tape two programs. We have been discussing the biblical meaning of love. And you can watch this program on Tuesday at 9:30 a.m. and Friday at 9 p.m. Coming up on Outreach Connection, hosted by Sherry McDaniel, this next week we have Patricia Tyler. And she is the house manager, I should say, at the Well House here in Quincy, Illinois. Gave us a lot of good information about the ministry work there. You can watch that on Monday, February 12th at 11 a.m., Wednesday, February 14th at 9 p.m., and Saturday, February 17th at 5 p.m. And coming up on Pastor Speaks this next week is Pastor James Bridges. He pastors Living Way Christian Fellowship in Hannibal, Missouri. And he brought a message, Living in the Second Mile. Very good message. You want to be sure and listen to that on Sunday, February the 11th at 2 p.m., Tuesday, February 13th at 1:30 p.m., or you could watch it on Wednesday, February 14th, Valentine's Day at 7:30 p.m. Coming up on the family movie night on Saturday, February the 17th at 8 p.m. and Sunday, February the 18th at 11:30 p.m. is John in Exile. And this is a one-man drama with James Moffat. Many of you remember James Moffat. He's had several shows here on WTJR. And he came here into the studio, and we actually recorded it here in the studio at WTJR. And it was a wonderful presentation. And so we want to show you now a promo of this movie, John in Exile.
His eyes are looking at me, from me to his mother. She comes to my arms. He rises on the nails. Woman, behold your son. Son, behold your mother. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Jesus stares at the horizon, his eyes dancing madly as if seeing horrors that even he who'd cast out demons could not bear to look on. He rises on the nails. My God! My God! Why have you forsaken me?
John in Exile, that'll be the movie we are re-airing. We've aired it before, as you could see the dates there. It was talking about July. And we have showed this a few times, but we will be showing it again on February 17th, that's a Saturday at 8 p.m., and on Sunday, February 18th at 11:30 p.m. It's a wonderful, wonderful drama, and I want to thank Pastor James Moffat for giving us the opportunity to tape that right here at WTJR. Amen. Well, I have no letters to share with you this week, so we're going to move to our bridge, and we're going to show you the video that our engineer, Jim Wilson, produced about the WTJR HD Fund.
Jim Wilson, the engineer here at WTJR, and we're right in the middle of a fundraiser for the Production 20,000 project, which is WTJR Production is converting from SD to HD, and we're going to need some new equipment to do that. We thank all the support that's already come in, but let's go right through the items specifically one by one here. We're going to need three JVC GYHM620U cameras. These cameras cost $2,625 a piece, giving a total of $7,875. Now, these are all current prices at the time that this video has been recorded. Now, we're setting these cameras up in the studio configuration, so we'll need some VeriZoom. The zoom focus controllers, these go down on the tripod arms and allow you to remote control the zoom focus and the iris in this case. We'll need three of those. They're $325 a piece. That'll be $975. For tripods, we're going with the Davis and Sanford Pro Vista Airlift Tripod with the FM18 head. These are $181 a piece, and these have dolly wheels, bringing us to a total of $543.45 for those three items. Now, each camera needs a camera cable. These are 100 feet long. These include the video, the power, the intercom. These are all bundled in one cable, the return video cable for the monitor. Those are $270 each, and that's $810. Then we need a data video ITC100 8-user wired intercom system with 4 belt packs and 4 headsets. They'll be $1,100. We need one of those. Now, each camera will need a power supply because we don't want to run them off batteries or run AC cords across the studio floor. And this will come from the control room on that camera cable. These are $40 each. These are 12-volt power supplies. We'll need 3 of them, $120. On top of the camera, we'll put a LVID Field Vision 7-inch monitor. This will sit on top of the camera, and that brings the total to $717 for 3 of those at $239 a piece. Now, for the tally lights in this system, they come through on the Data Video ITC100 system. Intercom system also has a tally light option. So this, for the studio camera configurations total, that's $12,140. Now let's move into the control room. The main item in the control room will be a Data Video SE 1200 6 input HD video switcher with an RMC260 control panel. This is sold as a bundle for $1,995. This is where you switch between the cameras, and it also has 2 inputs, one for the character generator and one for a computer. So you got 3 cameras and also a playback deck. I forgot to mention that. That'll be the 4th input. Then you got the character generator input. That's the 5th input. And then the 6th input will be a full screen computer input, what we basically call a Scala computer now. So we need a way to record the output, the HD SDI output of the switcher. So we're going with the HyperDeck. This records and plays back. And then we need a playback deck because we're going to be doing simultaneous recording and playback when we record shows live here. So we're going with a smaller version of that, which is the HyperDeck Studio Mini, which is $661. Then we're going with hard drives. One of them takes PC cards, so we need 2 of those. That'll be $135. The other one takes video SATA drives, $220 each, so that'll be $400. Then we need cables to tie this all together, be $200. So the total switching will be $4,175. Moving on to the character generator aspect of things, because we have to bring up phone numbers and stuff during our programs, we're going with the Data Video CG300 character generator kit. This will be $1,775. We need a computer to run that. So we're going with a refurb HP workstation from Newegg. That's $500. And a monitor for that will be $130, bringing that to $18,920. There'll be shipping on some of this too. This doesn't include all shipping. But so that's around $19,000, $18,920.45. Now there's 2 remaining items that aren't listed here. One is we have to bring HD video signal to all of our monitors in the facility. So we have to have HD wiring or converters to run to these monitors to bring our HD signal to the monitors on the studio, in the lobby, in the green room. And the second thing, if we have money left over, will be for our lighting system. Our main lighting dimmer pack is fried. So right now we're using on off switches only. So we're hoping to get a new dimmer system in under the total of $20,000. It may go a little bit over that for the lighting system, but that will be, if more money comes in, that's where it's going, into the lighting system. So if we get any price matching above the $20,000, that's where it's going, into the lighting system. So this is the WTJR HD project, and this is the rundown on it. And we thank you for your continued support. And remember, here at WTJR, we are working till Jesus returns. God bless you.
Thank you, Jim, for taking time to make that detailed because he can explain it so much better than me. And so you will know exactly what the equipment is that we're needing here to finish this project. And again, if you send a donation, please mark on it that it's for the HD fund, okay? So we get it in the right account. Thank you. Okay, well, let's move on here. We are praising God for the hope that we bring to you through CTN WTJR every day, and it's all because of the gospel of Jesus Christ, okay? Our hope is in Jesus Christ. And today we're using for our scripture Matthew 4:4. But he answered and said, "It is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God." And this comes out of the red letter words of Jesus. And this is a hardback booklet that CTN is offering for a love gift of $15. And this helps support CTN and all of the affiliate stations, of which WTJR is one of them. Amen. This is, like I said, a hardback book, and it talks about and how, well, Jesus spoke about how we are to live, his relationship with God, about the Holy Spirit, and Jesus talked about his overwhelming love for you. So there's 100 passages in here from the Bible. It's written by Jack Countryman. And I want to go to the first one that's in here. And again, it was that scripture from Matthew 4:4. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. Before Jesus began his earthly ministry, the Spirit led him into the wilderness where he would be tempted by the devil. After Jesus had fasted for 40 days and 40 nights, Satan challenged him to turn the desert rocks into bread, to meet his needs in his own time and in his own way without considering God's timing or ways. But when Jesus faced the temptation to create bread for himself, and just as in the two subsequent wilderness temptations, Jesus responded to Satan's words with the powerful words of God. Each time Jesus began with, "It is written." And each time Jesus quoted God's truth and silenced the enemy, Jesus knew that God would provide the needed food at the right time. Christians must know what God's word says. They also must be willing to trust his timing. When you choose to build your life on his word, you can, as Jesus did, stand strong against any temptation you find yourself facing. You can also trust him to provide for you according to his perfect will. Follow Jesus' example and confront every temptation with, "It is written." You will find strength in God's true word and the faith to trust in his timing. And I don't know if you've ever went into the New Testament, into the four Gospels, and just looked up the words in red. The red letters. They call this a red letter Bible that I have here. And I was noticing that chapter 4 and 5, 6, 7. Wow. Especially starting at 5. There, almost the whole chapter is red letters. Jesus speaking. Chapter 5, of course, was the Sermon on the Mount. Yes, blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of God. Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. Blessed are they which are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are ye when men shall revile you, persecute you, and shall say all manner of evil against you, falsely for my sake. Rejoice. These are Jesus' words. He says, rejoice. And he experienced this. He is giving us advice. He has already experienced these things. Yes. So his words, we can stand on his word. And he wants us to rejoice and be exceeding glad, for great is your reward in heaven, for so persecuted they the prophets which were before you. And he goes on to talk about how we're the salt of the earth, how we're the light. Oh, I just love to read those things. In chapter 6, the Lord's Prayer, the disciples ask him, teach us to pray, Master. Teach us to pray. And he talked about serving God only. He talked about judging not others. And it just goes on and on, the red letters in the gospel. Precious words Jesus spoke. So again, I want to encourage you. This red letter words of Jesus is a beautiful hardback book. Would make a wonderful gift for somebody. And there's information how you can get this. You can also go on our website, WTGR.org. And on that homepage there, there's a place you can just click on, and it'll take you right to where you can order it online there for a love gift of $15. The red letter words of Jesus. Discover the things Jesus thinks are most important and should be important to us in our life. If they were important to Jesus, they should be important to us. Like I said, there's more than 100 passages from the Bible that are considered with illustration, explanations, and he gives a background facts. Most of all, discovering God's word will breathe life into your relationship with him and help you draw close to the one who knows you fully and loves you completely. The red letter words of Jesus. And I would encourage you to get one for yourself and a gift for a friend. Maybe someone that's a new Christian, you know. Maybe as a gift, you know, there's some graduations coming up. Maybe give it to a couple getting married, you know, for them to sit and read together the words of Jesus. If we put Jesus in the center of our life and seek him first, he said all other things would fall in line, won't they? We got to keep Jesus the center of our life. God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. I pray you know Jesus today as your Savior and as your Lord. He becomes your Savior when you confess that you have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. He becomes your Lord when you ask him to come in and walk with you each day. Get to know Jesus. Get in your Bible each day. Read, start in the Gospels, and read, and you'll read the more beautiful story about the life of Jesus. But it hasn't ended there. One day he's coming back. Are you ready to meet Jesus? God bless.
Inside Report with founder and president Bob DeAndre.
Hello again, friends. Well, we're going through the book of Psalms, Psalm 73:26. And I want you to listen to this because it was my great desire, my flesh and my heart failed. And that wasn't my design.